transformation process. We need him to touch our hearts and our minds on a continual basis. And keep in mind, this is like a swimming pool. Sunday, Wednesday, the corporate meetings are supposed to be like a swimming pool. There's one thing, if you stand out in the rain, you get a little water in your hair and on your shoulders, and it doesn't run down into the inner section or into the whole body or the whole mind. Instead, you just get a little bit soaked, and sometimes that can be wet and cold. But a good hot tub or a good swimming pool of coming and getting in, I don't know if you know this or not, but swimming pools have chlorine in them, you know, that stuff that we complain about. But it gets rid of all the microorganisms on the body. It kills every little infection that's on the body. It gets between the toes, under the toenails, if you soak in it long enough. That's what a corporate meeting is for. It's for us to come and soak into the Lord's presence and let him wash over us and cleanse us and actually just soak in his presence, so that there's something that he does to our mind and to our heart to transform us. That we can sense him more, that we can hear him more, that he can give us new and fresh hope. And oh my goodness, that he could give us direction for the future, direction of what we're supposed to be doing next, direction of the hopes of the future, because he has a future planned for us. Well, we can try to plan our future, and our futures are cyclical. We plan it and it goes in a loop and fail. We plan it and it goes in a loop and fail. But we're following a timeline this way that we look more like circus acrobats doing this. But God's plan for us is one that if we can learn to hear him and then say, yes, Lord, not my way, but yours. Yes, it will work for me doing it your way. Then we get on an even plane with him, and we hold his hand. As little as we are, we're walking alongside him. And then he says, now there's a step up here. And what we see is this huge cliff of, oh, there's no way I could ever climb that. We want to go back and walk around on the pathway that we were on because it looks too tall. There's too much that we would have to overcome, too much that we would have to change. But if we'll only keep our eyes upon him, he with his hand will help us up that next step. And it becomes a whole new plane of relational functionality with him. A whole new plane of truth and reality with him. So ask him to come and speak to you this morning. You need him to speak to your heart. You need him to give you a different picture of who you are and who he can make you into. We get pretty disgusted looking at ourselves in the mirror and looking at ourselves and the things that we've done and think there's no hope. But yet he looks at Jesus, his son, in us, and he says, there's all the hope in the world. The Lord is there. I sent him. And Jesus begins to speak, and he says, what do you mean there's no hope? I'm in here. Just listen to my spirit, and I'll transform you. So the two of them can work hand in hand to do things that man cannot do. So would you pray and ask the Lord to come and speak to you? Would you pray and ask him to touch you? Would you pray and ask him to make himself known to you as we worship? Give him your heart and worship him with all your heart this morning, with abandonment and love upon him, that he might in turn love upon you. Matter of fact, everything we do towards him, he pressed down and shakes and measures out 10 times as much and pours it back upon us. So if we come expectant and with hope to see him and to worship him, shouldn't he come with the expectation of, oh, well, let me make myself known to you. Now, if you have a list, you know that list that hits the floor when you hold it up. We say, wait a minute, I got one thing I want to talk to you about, and you hold it up and the scroll is out and it keeps rolling across the floor. If you have that, can you set that aside for just a moment? Because we don't need answers on our list. We need to ask different questions. Actually, we need to listen to what the questions are. And so just turn loose to that list and let's listen to him. Ask him to speak to you, not about your list, but about you and him. Worship him with all your heart this morning. Will you bow your head, please? Lord, we humbly come before you. we declare we delight in you. We want to honor you and give you our hearts and our minds, our bodies, and everything that's within us. We declare we need you. We need you, Lord. We need you because you know the future, and you're the only one that can supply in us that which we do not have. You're the only one that can give us peace, that we can walk in accord with you. You're the only one that can change our lives from one of hardness and emptiness into one of joy and fullness of you. So come, Lord Jesus. Receive our worship and praise. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night, His light will shine. God is good. God is good all the time. Shadows all around. Do not fear. He will guide you. He will keep you safe and sound. As He has promised to never leave you or forsake you. Good all the time. He put a song of praise.
light will shine. God is good. God is good. Yes, God is good. God is good.
You are good, Lord.
Yes,
you are
Jesus.
Good.
Oh, Father, how we love you. We want to declare your goodness among us this morning, Lord Jesus.
To Above all, But in the great house, there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor. Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from the latter, he'll be a vessel for honor, sanctified and useful for the master, prepared for every good work. Flee also youthful lust, but pursue righteousness, faith, love, peace with those who call on the name of the Lord out of a pure heart. I say to you, it is not the construct of the vessel, whether it be of gold or silver, clay or wood, that is of importance. What is of importance is whether it is sanctified and set apart for my use. I say this begins with a decision on your part to be sanctified, to be set apart, to be called, to respond to my calling and my anointing. Oh, can I not change clay and wood into gold and silver? I say to you, my children, nothing is beyond me. But I also say to you that sometimes it is the common vessel that I use for my purposes. I have set apart and established good works for you from the very foundations of the world, before time began. I call you to be my vessel. Come, whether gold or whether silver, whether clay or whether wood, I sanctify you by the power and working of my Holy Spirit, whom I have given freely to you. Call upon me. I will rescue you, set you apart. I have great works of service for you. Call upon me that you might accomplish all that I desire in your life, that you might be fulfilled in every way. I am the Lord your God who calls you. I call you today. Hear my voice. Respond to me, for I love you deeply. You are my children.
I cannot think of any greater honor than to be a vessel of yours. Just an instrument in your hand, Lord. The hand of the Holy One. The hand of the King of the universe. The hand of Alpha and Omega, oh Lord. What greater honor that we would surrender to your hand. That we would be made fit to be used by you, Lord. What greater honor could you bestow on a creature, on one of your creation? Oh, use us, Lord. We want to surrender, Lord, our ways and our thoughts and our ideas and our desires.
Thank you. Faithful.
filled with my glory. There's no conflict in the heavens. For I stand as king. My angels are filled with joy to accomplish the work that is ahead. They're ecstatic about the things that they've accomplished that I've sent them to do. And I have sent them to help you. And I have selected you to be ecstatic about the things I have for you to do. It will take a different mindset, but I'm willing to help you in that too. I'm willing to change and everything that's within your thinking and reprogram you. You need that. But the enemy has come and dropped things in your soup that make it bitter. And life is empty in many ways, but it will not be empty if you listen to me. I've selected you to be my child, to walk with me, to stand with me and sit with me. I've selected you for you to hear my voice and learn of my ways. Man on his own cannot do this, and the enemy cannot help you in this. It is only I who can help you in this, for I am your living and loving God, and I can transform you from your strong nature into a strong will to accomplish my will. It is not for me to try to break you. It is for you to come and lay your life before me. Then I will orchestrate it. That I will fill it with love and with peace. That I will fill it with purpose. This is my heart towards you, my love. So fear not, and run after me and chase after me, for I can be found.
Holy, holy, holy.
you the King of Kings.